Today, I'm gonna try making my glass vase look like aged pottery. My plan is to make this as non-toxic as possible, as quick as possible, because I have a little baby that will probably need me in like 10 minutes. So I'm hoping to do it in 3 easy steps. I looked at a ton of Pinterest DIYs and I do not wanna mix any concrete or anything like that. Just paint, maybe some baking soda. Okay, let's do this. First step is washing it. I actually decided to add a fourth step and do some primer on it. I'm sure any kind of primer you have would work. I just want to make sure this actually sticks on without me just lightly scratching it and it coming off. I'm using the gripper primer. I had this left over from my floor painting project. I'm just going to apply a thin coat of it all around. Okay, while that's drying, we're going to go for a walk. Yeah, Matthew? You're going to go get some fresh air. And the colors we're working with today is creamy mushroom and Spanish sand. These are just some testers I had left over. As long as it's one color is darker, one color is lighter in beige tones. First up is mixing the darker beige with some baking soda and applying it onto the vase. There is no right amount of baking soda. I like to add quite a bit because it gives it more texture. To get even more texture, once the paint kind of gets tacky in some areas, I'll go over it and just kind of give it a few more brush strokes to give it a rougher texture. Okay, so I also just learned the hard way that it needs to be propped up on something while you're painting the bottom because it dries and gets stuck to whichever surface you have it lying on and then peels the paint off, so. Okay, I'm doing the lighter color now. I'm gonna mix in some baking soda. So here's the difference between my darker color and my lighter color. You can still see that this one's pretty creamy. It's not like a white color. And then I'm just gonna apply it kind of messy all around. And I'm almost like dry brushing it on. So I'm not completely covering the color under. Also, make sure that your brush strokes are not perfect, because the more perfect they are, the less aged it will look. If you kind of do it in circular motions and then spread it out a little bit, just like that, then it looks more messy that way versus you having like long brush strokes, unless that's the look you're going for. For the last step, I'm gonna take this special dark finishing wax and I'm gonna apply some onto a brush. And then I'm just gonna brush it over the surface. And I'm not gonna do too much, and in some areas I'll do it darker, but this is just to give it like a, or like an aged look, even more than what it already has on this side, because I feel like this one just doesn't have enough like depth in it. So here's some close-ups on the side that I added that special dark wax on. As you can see, it kind of gives it, makes the texture kind of pop more in some areas. And I'm not applying it to the whole vase. I'm actually just gonna go like in sections and apply it. Little goes a long way. Here's how it turned out. So this definitely didn't take me 10 minutes like I was hoping, but I would totally do it again. I wanna try this with different colors and maybe for the last step, applying dirt instead of that special dark wax.
Okay, and that's it for this video. We're gonna go take a nap. We'll see you guys next time. Bye.